Hello, my friends! Welcome to the 50th episode of the Item Guide series. Today, we will talk about the last four magic items: Holy Crystal, Ice Queen Wand, Glowing Wand, and Lightning Truncheon. You may notice that I'm pushing to end this series, because I want to include the Create Your Own Build Guide, because I want to include the Create Your Own Build video into the rank up series I'm working on. So we have no time to waste today, let's jump right into today's topic and talk about Holy Crystal. As always, first the stats. You simply get 100 magic power. This item has one effect, and it's called Mystery. You gain 21 to 35% magic power. The amount is depending on your hero's level. So if we do the math, let's say your hero is on level 12 and has 300 magic power, your magic power increases to 396, because it's increased by 32%. On level 15, it would increase to 405. Otherwise, there's no demonstration needed, I think. This is an item you usually should build as your 4th or 5th item. After you have already built your other core items, then increases your magic power. Like this, it gives you a very nice mid-game power spike. I wouldn't build it as your first core item, because it's not as effective as other items with effect that help you much more in the early game. Examples are Enchanted Talisman, Clock of Destiny, Lightning Truncheon, Glowing Wand, or Concentrated Energy. I also wouldn't build it as your last item, because then you wasted a lot of potential extra damage that you would have early in the game from this item. When we are talking about the heroes you should build it on, you can basically build it on any hero which uses a build that increases the hero's magic power. You can't really go wrong with this item, as long as you have items that increase your magic power. The higher the amount of magic power is you get from the other items, the more effective the passive of Holy Crystal becomes, of course. I would love to have a cool transition now to Ice Queen Wand, but I couldn't think of one. Sad life. You get plus 75 magic power, plus 10% magic lifesteal, plus 150 mana, and plus 7% movement speed. As a quick reminder, magic lifesteal restores an amount of HP you deal as magic damage, regardless if you deal it with basic attacks or skills. With 10% magic lifesteal, you would for example restore 50 HP when you deal 500 magic damage. This item also has one effect, and it's called Icebound. Skill damage slows the enemy's hero by 15% for 3 seconds. This can stack up to 2 times, so in total, 30%. Let's jump right into the demonstration. I'm using one of my wife's favorite heroes, Kadita, for the demonstration. Once I hit bot Layla with the skill, she runs slower than before. After each hit with the skill, the effect's duration is resetted to 3 seconds again. So in theory, you could slow an enemy hero forever, if you can hit them with the skill every 3 seconds. This effect also doesn't have a cooldown. You can only lose the 2 stacks. Now, on which hero should you build this item? Usually this item is a good choice for DPS / poke mages that can deal a large amount of damage with multiple hits. In order to be able to deal that damage, they must ensure that their target can escape them. And for that purpose, the passive effect of Ice Queen Wand is perfect. Example for this kind of heroes are Sicilian, Chang'e, Cyclops, Kimmy, Valir, Eve, or Zask. You don't need to build this item on one-shot mages, because they usually have a stun ability, followed by one hard hit. There's no need to slow the enemy, when they are stunned anyway. For this kind of heroes, you better build an item like Lightning Truncheon. Nice transition, yes! You get plus 75 magic power, plus 300 mana, and plus 10% cooldown reduction. This item has one effect, and it's called Resonate. If you deal skill damage to an enemy, the passive effect will deal 20 to 1000 magic damage up to 3 enemies. This effect has a 6 second cooldown, and the magic damage scales with the hero's max mana. With the test I've made, you need around 3800 mana to reach a max amount of damage. Now, let's talk about the heroes you should build it on. As I said before, this item can be used by burst mages, and basically all other mages that doesn't need any other items more in the early game. For example, mana hungry mages who need a Enchanted Talisman, or as mentioned before, Ice Queen Wand for DPS mages. A very good combination is this item together with Clock of Destiny. These two items together already give you 900 mana, which is a very nice boost for the passive effect of Lightning Truncheon. If you build Clock of Destiny, you should definitely try to include Lightning Truncheon as well. When your hero reaches the max level, your mana should be high enough that you will deal together with these two items around 800 to 900 damage, which is a huge amount, especially against squishy heroes. This effect also works really good when your hero deals AoE damage, because this effect can apply up to 3 heroes at the same time. So, if you have an AoE effect and the passive is ready, make sure to use your AoE skill first and hit multiple enemies. so you will outshine your allies and become the MVP. And talking about shining, let's continue with the last item for today, Glowing Wand. I'm really proud of this transition. You get plus 400 HP, plus 75 magic power, and plus 5% movement speed. It has one passive effect, and it's called Scorch? Are you pronouncing it like this? I'm not sure. When you deal skill damage, your target burns for 3 seconds, dealing 1% of the target's max HP as magic damage per second. If you hit the enemy multiple times in a short duration, it can increase up to 2%. Let's check how it works. As you can see, after I dealt one-time damage with the skill, Bot Layla received 31 magic damage each second. Now, after I hit her twice in a short time, the damage increases to 1.5%, and after 3 hits, to 2% damage of her max HP. The burning continues as long as you hit the enemy with a skill in between the 3 seconds. So for example, if you hit an enemy with Chang'e's ult, it will be effective for quite some time. Considering that Chang'e's ult lasts for 4 seconds, you can expect to deal 11% of the enemy's max HP as damage, because the passive burns the enemy 6 times. Why 11% and not 12, you may ask? The first burn only deals 1% max HP damage, because it's directly active after the first hit. So obviously, this item is only something for heroes who are able to deal continuously magic damage. Examples are Chang'e, Cecilion, Kimmy, or some other forgotten heroes who are actually going to receive a revamp. Yay! Now, go and check out the whole item guide playlist if you haven't already. Thank you all for your support and see you next time. Have a great day!